Right, so hello viewers, and welcome back to Battleplan American Civil War. So, last time we had left off with Battle 3, and we're moving on to Battle 4 now. So, we have a little bit of a mix-up inside the camp here, as some of you guys may have noticed. It says here, now that we had fought 4 battles instead of 3. And, well, this is because I tried to check out the next battle. It's the Battle of Antietam, which was one of the more bloody battles during the Civil War. And unfortunately what happened was that I started the battle because I wanted to check it out, and I had surrendered it, and for whatever reason the game seems to log pretty much everything inside the campaign, and from the looks of it, it just moves you on to the next battle. So what we're going to do here is that we're going to check out the Battle of Antietam here inside the quick battle area of the map, and really resume our campaign next time inside the battle over here. So, I'll give you guys a brief overview of the scenario once again. This is a battle fought by a pretty high quality force of 40,000 Confederate men versus an army of 80,000 Union men. And this happened in September 1862, so that this time the Union was, although getting better and better over time. And in general, this battle, I believe it came out as a Union victory, in the sense that it forced the Confederates to go south to retreat and to rebuild their army, while the actual battle here should be a draw, which is kind of difficult to obtain, seeing as how that would require the enemy to give up one of these locations, and us to have one of them. So, yeah, that's sort of that. I really don't know how this battle will turn out, but I mean, so far the game has been surprisingly easy, although I've got to say this battle is actually kind of challenging. So, starting off, we get a lot of infantry this time. Like I said, I mean, the Union did have some army reorganization reforms and general things to improve its quality. So now, we have a large number of these 1,000 Union blocks of just infantry effectively there. We have a lot of cavalry on the flanks of our forces, oddly enough. I don't really know why that's that, but we do have those. We have a lot of cannons outside this battle. Single transport supply wagon and single leader here. So, how the game models this battle is that, from the looks of it, we start off with 42 units, with 18 en route, and the Confederates going on the defense start up with 43, with 5 en route. So, either way, this is going to be a huge clash where we effectively throw units to effectively decide a winner here. But that aside, checking out the map, this features quite a deadly defense. Namely, in order to capture Sharpsburg itself, we'll have to fight through quite a dense urban sprawl, and bear in mind that I've checked this out, and the combat inside this area is highly disruptive on morale, but at the same time, the losses are very, very small, so this will be a critical area. On the field here, Bloody Lane here is effectively a defensive belt. It's the, I believe, the same thing that our entrenching tool can build. So it's quite a garrisoned off position, especially with the West Woods on the side here, making it quite difficult to breach this line. And over here, I think this is the main strong point of the enemy's defense at Lower Bridge. A, the enemy can blow up the bridge is one thing, but B, they'll have guns on the top of this area, and they also have a small force guarding this fort, so we can't exactly just hit them through the back door like that. So, anyhow, my general strategy for this battle would be, first and foremost, get the guns to move, and I want the guns to effectively assemble the sides here to really just pummel the central area that is Bloody Lane. So do that, also move a few more guns forwards, and in general we want our guns to provide constant firing support onto this lane area, and with that said, we'll try to base our maneuvers off of that. Namely, I think I'll try to go for Dunker Church here and Lower Bridge, because they seem to be, I'd say, more economical objectives rather than time that we'd have to waste trying to get to Sharpsburg. So I'll get those movements to go on first and foremost. I'll get these other artillery pieces to join on in here and there. And in general, we'll see what we can do here. Now, these cavalry units are a mixture, like our lower units, of low veterancy units and high veterancy units, so I'm not really sure how we'll use them just yet. Namely, I mean, cavalry changed quite a bit during history, and in this time, these units aren't exactly front fighting units. I'd say that they're more useful for raiding and for reconnaissance more than anything. But seeing as they start off inside the middle of the enemy's lines here, we might as well use them. And I'm going to issue them a series of broad strokes of attack orders effectively, hopefully to make some sort of a gap here in the area. And in general, I just want them to break through over there. So I think we'll do a wide offensive like that, starting off. On the side here, Dunkirk Church I'm going to attack later on, but I want to break through the center here. First and foremost, in the meantime, what I want to do here is that I just want to get my forces to assemble inside the forts over here, where they'll be nice and covered by our, rather by the forces themselves and by their adjacent troops. And I'm going to see whether or not we can, say, hopefully distract the guards on Bloody Lane by pressing onto one of their flanks. Hopefully it'll get the troops outside of Dunker Church, and going from there we could then move forwards and really drive through the offensive like that. And in the meantime, I'm just going to funnel troops inside this area. And I think that'll be the starting orders. I'll move our HQ up as well, so then we can hopefully get our orders relayed a bit faster. And now, on the side location here, this is going to be a very precarious location at Lower Bridge. I'm going to send a small force of infantry around the sides, but the main fighting, I think, will just happen around the bridge head here. Although, do bear in mind that I believe the AI will blow up that bridge as a trigger event, more so than anything, so that's definitely one consideration. But I think we'll just start off our offensive like this. And I'm going to move my HQ, of course, to a better location so that they can function better and relay orders faster. Right, so our cavalry is going to engage here. Like I said, strong Confederate defense. They're going to be supplemented by my infantry troops here, so which can hopefully flank the enemy and make a few breaks through that this area over here. This seems to be a weak line inside the enemy's defense. So we're going to press through this area, and we're going to see whether or not we can hopefully drive our troops straight through that area. Now, at Dunker's Bridge, it looks like some of our troops are fighting them, so that's good. I'm going to get these guys to try to storm across this bridge as best as they can. One of the things that we had to note is that I don't want my guns firing on that location just yet, because I know for a fact that they'll inherently damage the bridge and collapse it, so we'll let them do their own thing, hopefully give them another order to shoot at somewhere else for now. Right, so those guns should be just doing their thing from there. And over here I'm going to give our infantry some movement orders in just a little bit. And there we go. Our troops are moving forwards. It looks like we got a little briefing here. Let's see, what is this? The enemy has abandoned Sharpsburg. So currently, that is actually quite a good thing. So now we can get a draw, provided that the enemy keeps Sharpsburg neutral. And as I said, yeah, guns on top of the hills here. And what I think I'll do is we're going to try to flank them. I'm not terribly sure whether or not this will work, but we'll try to funnel three units straight through that gap, and we'll see whether or not we can break through over there. In the meantime, it looks like Longstreet's troops here, there are two veterancy troops, although they seem to be cautious, is guarding this bridge here. So we're going to try to get Nagel Burnside's corps to move forwards here. They are an aggressive leader. This is something that I don't think we've seen before. These guys will be able to hold their ranks quite nicely, and they won't reject orders as calmly as other leaders. So hopefully we'll be able to get them to make a charge. And what I'm going to do here is that I'm going to use quite a liberal amount of the orders from my headquarters here, the relay button, or rally button, to hopefully get them to move ever faster and into the fight like such. Now, in the meantime, I think what we'll do here is that while the cavalry is fighting inside the center of the lines and making good progress there, I'm going to get my infantrymen to assemble. And I'm going to use two paths here just because in the past, I mean, we've seen that infantry moving through one area do disrupt each other. And the second thing is that for whatever reason, walking past middle bridge here with infantry seemed to really mess up the game, and the troops will just infinitely build pontoon bridges. So we'll do that, and we'll see whether or not we can hopefully make some progress here or there. Right, so these guys are getting their orders. They will hopefully move past this ford. This ford, however, will be guarded by, from the looks of it, one pack of infantry. Nope, these guys. Squeeze right through. These guys are engaging the guns. And overall, it looks like we're making quite some progress. And yeah, like I said, I mean, for whatever reason, these infantry groups, they really seem to rather build pontoon bridges over middle bridge than actually use the bridge itself. It's kind of weird, but all right. So they'll be doing that, and from the looks of it, we're making good progress inside the middle of the map here. And let's try to exploit that to our advantage. So I see a little tiny brawl being commenced over here. And I'm going to get our guys to really kick up the fight. I'm going to see whether or not we can, say, swarm Dunker Church over here by launching a enveloping attack from the sides like such. Send some more of these guys forwards. And I think for this battle, we'll just have to command from this far off perspective, seeing as how anything else will be where the game runs too fast to command from anywhere else. Overall, looks like we're making decent progress. Things are, we're flanking the cannons over there near Bloody Lane. Checking out the losses, we've taken out 5 of the enemy's troops, they've taken out 1 of ours. I think it's time to bring our HQ, not to build a pontoon bridge, but to go over middle bridge and to take command over there. Over here, yeah, lower bridge is going to be a bit of a grindcore battle. We'll let that happen. Let's see. Here's what we'll do. We'll get Burnside's core from over here. We're Idwing. Sorry. It looks like Burnside's core encompasses all of these units. But, yeah, the actual leader is this person. It looks like they'll be brawling out with those units, so that's good. We want to get up and take those guns. So we'll send these troops around to do that and to obviously take the crossing. And let's see what we can do here. We'll get those guys to do their actions over here. I think I'll actually build a... I think I'll actually build a few pontoon bridges inside this area purposely this time. There we go. So we'll try to cross over here and there, and we'll try to flank lower bridge like that. In the meantime, inside this area, it looks like our troops are quite steady, so I'll get them to move forwards, sweep through these locations, and try their best to take out these guns over here. And we'll just throw our guys into the fray like that, I guess. Lots of pointy arrows being drawn on the map today. So we'll send those troops off, and let's see what else we can do. So these two gun batteries are actually out of range, so I'm going to push them over the bridge here, and I'm going to see whether or not we can hopefully get a extended forward firing position over there. Over here inside this area, I'm going to give our guys some orders to advance forwards like that. That should keep Dunker Church isolated for now, and it looks like Dunker Church will break fairly soon. So Jackson's corps is holding up over here. They have 400, 500-ish troops, but they have very low morale, so hopefully they'll break very soon. Orders are going to be issued. Some of them will be rejected. Some of them will be delayed, of course. Though it looks like we're moving... No, don't build another pontoon bridge. No. Oh. And unfortunately, we can't cancel those very easily, but oh well. Get those things to go forwards. Hopefully our troops will go forwards here. And looks like we have, we've contested Dunker Church over here. And perfect, our reinforcements have arrived. Yeah, so in our reinforcements, we gained some more infantry, and namely just some more general troops in here. So here's what we'll do. We'll send some of the guns forward just as such. I'm going to take the infantry, and we're just going to move them to the center of the map like that. And right now, like I said, I mean, Lower Bridge here is quite a difficult point to take out, especially once they've collapsed the bridge, as you may have noticed here. So we'll try to isolate, or rather, we'll try to disable this location from our perspective and theirs by just blowing the heck out of it with these gun arrays. And in the meantime, it looks like Sharpsburg is being reinforced, but we might have a better chance in grabbing that. So we'll see how this goes, but like I said, I mean, this is a point where the game gets a tad more difficult. Now, hopefully, once these troops sneak through here, they'll be able to fight the two troops here on an even footing and hopefully make some progress. Let's see. So, well, not bad, but not great. I'm gonna get these guns to fire on that position as well. Let's see whether or not we can hopefully make a push for Sharpsburg like that. Just a one-off attack, seeing as how currently Bloody Lane is heavily, heavily disrupted. And it looks like, oh, yikes, we have a lot of broken troops. So what we're going to do here is that we're going to send our leader around and hopefully rally these guys. I see that there's roughly a quarter of a battle left, so we're going to use a rally command. Hopefully that'll summon some of these guys up. And once they're summoned up, if you will, we can hopefully give them a marching order. It looks like a few of them already. And we'll give them the order to just make a drive for Sharpsburg right now. It's kind of gamey, but we'll just launch an overarching attack here. And looks like that area will be handled. I'll shift my leader around here. And it looks like Dunker, or Lower Bridge here, is captured, so that's not bad either. In that case, I'm going to shift my leader to the middle of the map over there, so that he can provide an even further morale boost to the troops moving into Sharpsburg. And I don't think we'll have to use any strategy this time. It'll just be mobs and mobs of attacks for now. And we'll see what we can do in that regards. Over here, we're still building these useless pontoon bridges for whatever reason. But let's see. Right, so the Battle of Antietam here finished as a draw. Looks like we issued nearly just a little under 150 orders. Did massive casualties, but at the very end of the day, it looks like we got the historical result here, which was, of course, a draw. And overall, I mean, again, tons of losses for the enemy. But evidently, I mean, we required two of the points here to get the draw instead of a victory. So, oh well, I guess the game balances a tad off on that regards. But hey, anyhow, it looks like a pretty fun battle nonetheless. And I think I'll just see you guys next time when we move on, hopefully inside the official campaign rather than the quick battles here.